right. So today we're going to look at volume, and in particular additive volume. We have a shape here with two different shapes that are put together. And what we want to do is find the volume of each one by finding the length, width, and the height. Now, you know that we multiply when we're finding volume. So let's take the first shape up here and let's look at the length, which is 3. And we multiply it times the width, which is 4, and the height is 5. Okay, so we can find the volume for this particular shape. 3 times 4 is 12, and 12, so 12 times 5 is 60. And this is centimeters cubed. This is the volume for the first shape. Now, let's find the volume for the second shape. I always like to write the formula out to fill in the values so that you make sure that you fill in those correctly. Length, 10, times the width, which is 4, and the height is 4. All right, 10 times 4 is 40. And 40 times 4 is 160, and that is centimeters cubed. Now, the first shape has the volume of 60, and the second shape has the volume of 160. So let's add those together. 160 and 60. And we get the additive volume of 220 centimeters cubed. Okay, so just to recap, the volume of the first shape is 60, and the volume of the second shape is 160. So when we add these together, we get the additive volume of 220 centimeters cubed. Okay, so on this problem, the given information we have is the additive volume is 400 centimeters cubed. So we are given all the dimensions for this figure, but there is a missing dimension on this one. All right, so we have 12, and we know that we have 5, and we have 5. So we can go ahead and find the volume for this particular figure, and then I'll show you how to do that, the next one. So 12 times 5 is 60, and 60 times 5 is 300. So we know this shape right here is 300 centimeters cubed. So now if you go back to your given information, which is 400, we know that 400 minus 300 is 100. So this shape has to be 100. Right? So knowing that, let's look to see what the values that are given up to this point. We have 5 times 5, and we know 5 times 5 is 25. Well, what times 5, or 25, will equal 100? And it's 4, right? So we can fill in this little missing value with 4. 25 times 4 equals 100, and 100 plus 300 equals 400. Okay, so this is another way to find the additive volume when you're given the total and you have a missing dimension. All right, so here's the next type of problem that I want to show you. This is also additive volume. Sometimes you're given a shape and you can see that two shapes have been combined, and you have to break it apart in order to find the volume of each one. So let's break this one apart, and let's look at this line right here, and let's continue the line. Let's draw a little dotted line to show how that we could separate this into two different shapes. So you have the top shape, and now we have this bottom shape. All right, so we're going to look at the values for the top. You have the You see a width of 5, you see a height of 5, and this length right here is not given. So we have to figure out what is that particular value. We can do it because we can look below and we can see you follow the line that's the same, you see the same direction, you come below and do you see, are there other lines that are in that same direction? Sure, right here. So you have one right here, 12, and this would be the distance right here, 12, and then the rest of it is 8. So from here to here would be 8. So we can add 12 plus 8 and get a value of 20. So this is how we would find the length, and this would be 20 feet. Now we can continue and find the volume of the first shape. So 20 times 5 times 5. And we know that 20 times 5 is 100, and 100 times 5 is 500. Now this is feet, and this is cubic feet. And let's look and see what the dimensions are of the smaller shape underneath. We already have that this value is labeled 8. And we don't know what this is because this total length from on this side is 10. So we're gonna have to figure out what is this distance from here to here, okay? And we also need to know what this distance is, this width right here. Look and see if you see another line that is diagonal in this same direction anywhere else. And you see, this one's not labeled, but look right here. This one's labeled. So here we are, 5, and this is also going to be 5. So that's how you can find that missing value. Okay, so now we have 8 and we have 5. Let's find what the height would be for this particular shape. So look and see if there's any place else on this shape with the vertical lines that are labeled. Here's a vertical line, here's a vertical line. It's not labeled, but here's one. This is labeled. This is very important to find. So this 5, if this particular height is 5 and this particular is 10, we can determine what this is. 10 minus 5 has to be 5. So here's our 5 feet. Now we have all three dimensions and we can determine the volume of this lower shape. So we can take 8 times 5 times 5. 8 times 5 is 40. 40 times 5 is 200. Now, all we have to do is combine these two shapes because we know that this is 500, and if this is 200, 500 plus 200 is the total volume of 700 feet cubed, okay? Right here. So this is our total volume. All right, so let's recap real quickly. What we did is we found the missing values by looking at the parallel lines right here. We found the missing 20 and we were able to find the top volume of 500. Then we went to the lower shape and we found the missing values by looking at the parallel lines. You find a line here, this is parallel with this one, and that's how you can find the 5, and this is 5. And then we also found the value of the 5 by looking for another parallel line. And we were able to say 10 minus 5 is 5 to find those three values. And then we added them together to get our additive volume. All right, there you go.